Hello again, folks. And now that we've created our company file, we will do a basic file setup. These are the things that we would do to the file regardless of what type of company we have. But once we're done setting up the file this way, it will be easier to use it as a contractor. Now, the first thing we're going to do is set the preferences. In QuickBooks, the preferences are the options, the defaults, the automatic settings or behaviors of the file once you create the file. It behaves the way QuickBooks company thinks most businesses need, and you have to adjust these options, defaults, and settings to make it behave the way you need. So, what settings or options do we need to change? Well, first, we do not want QuickBooks to warn us every time a transaction is dated too far in the past or the future. So, that means on the day that we record a transaction, if we put the date of the transaction too far ahead of the date that the computer says is current, QuickBooks will distract us with a warning message. But we're going to be doing that all throughout this course, and we don't want to be distracted by that. So from the top left, click Edit, Preferences, and this is your defaults window, the preferences window. You may notice that as you click the different categories on the left, different details show up in the right panel. Each of these are different categories of preferences, and within each category, there's a company preference section and a my preference section. If you go to the top and you click accounting and then click company preference, you will see that there are two check marks here that tell QuickBooks if a transaction is dated too far in the past or too far in the future when you record it, you want QuickBooks to give you a pop-up warning. Well, we don't want that warning, so we have to click here. Make sure you click to remove the check marks, then click OK, and now we don't have to worry about being distracted with a message that warns us about the date of the transaction. What else do we need to change? Well, we do not want QuickBooks to save the windows on the open desktop. That means if we're using QuickBooks during a session and we have a whole bunch of windows open, we don't want QuickBooks to reopen all of those windows from the previous session, but it will if we don't change the preference. From the top left, click Edit Preferences, then click Desktop View. And instead of allowing it to save when closing the desktop, click Don't Save when it closes the desktop. Click OK, and now we don't have to worry about that either. What else will we change? Well, there's a window called the Home window that opens when we open the file. And that Home window, you could always reopen here by clicking Help. Or excuse me, not Help. You could always click Company Homepage. Now, this Home page simply has icons that are shortcuts to the main menu. But these are not necessarily the icons that we need. And it's very distracting when the computer makes this window open up and we have to bother closing it every time. So let's tell QuickBooks that we don't want this open when we open the file. From the top left, click Edit Preferences. And then, of course, again, click Desktop View. Make sure you're in the My Preferences tab. And then remove the check mark here. Click it, Show Homepage when opening company file. Click OK. And now we won't have to bother closing the home page every time. Now, we want to turn off all pop-up advertisements that will distract us as we try to learn QuickBooks. From the top left, click Edit, Preferences. And this time we go down to the general category of preferences. And again, make sure the My Preferences tab is chosen. And then click the little box here to place a check mark where it says, turn off pop-up messages for products and services. Now click OK, and we don't have to worry about pop-up messages for products and services. What else? We need to be able to deposit money directly into the bank account. The way it's set up now, you cannot record a payment directly into your bank account. You have to do two steps. So this is something that will become relevant a little bit later in the course. But from the top left, click Edit Preferences and go down to where it says Payments. And in the Company Preference tab, this check mark you must remove. Right now, every time you receive a payment, QuickBooks by default, QuickBooks will automatically record that payment in an account called Undeposited Funds, and it will not let you record it directly into your bank account. But if we remove this check mark, QuickBooks will allow us an option to record the payment directly into our bank's records. We click OK, and now we're set up with that feature. There's only two more. We have to turn on estimates and progress invoicing. So let's do that. Edit preferences. You know, if you're a contractor, you come down here, time and expense. Time and expense is the category. Company preferences the tab. Do you track time? If it says no, click yes. Now, as far as reimbursable expenses, we'll come back to this option later in the course. Now, if you want to choose a different preference without closing the window, if you click a different category, you will notice, well, actually, we didn't change anything, but we want to make sure it says we want to turn on estimates and progress invoicing. So where is that? Well, if you come here with jobs and estimates is the category. Now, if you're a contractor, do you create estimates? Make sure yes is chosen. Do you do progress invoicing? In this course, that's an additional feature that we will learn. So click yes, we do progress invoicing. Now we click OK, and now we're able to do what many contractors need to do, progress invoicing. And the last preference we will set, we do track time. So if we come here and we type Edit Preferences, and we scroll all the way down, time and expense, company preference, do you track time? Make sure yes is chosen, because we will be tracking time later, and we will be referring back to these preferences when we get up to the video about tracking time. So you might not see the result of all the settings that we changed in this video, but as you use QuickBooks, certain features will be available that will not be available if you did not properly click on these options or on these settings.